Hello, my name is David Faure and I work for KDAB. Imagine you're working on a very complex Qt Widgets based application and you have trouble finding your way around. Maybe because it was written by your customer or by coworkers, or maybe by yourself 5 years ago and you forgot all about it. The kind of problems we are going to solve together are like you are running the application, you see widgets, but you don't know what's the class name of the widget or where in the code the widget is created. And we will see in part two how to actually do that. Then in part three, we will have a look at fixing double margins, which is something that happens when visually you see widgets that are not properly aligned. And maybe that's because one of them has margin inside and then the widgets inside are not properly aligned. We'll see what it looks like in part three and how to debug that. Then in part four, we will look at sizing issues. For instance, you have a widget that you try to resize down to make it smaller and it refuses to let you do that. And even if we don't know the code, we can find out why that widget is behaving that way and we can investigate and fix the problem and actually fix the code in the end. Then we will have a look at identifying context menus. They are a little bit different from widgets from part two because, of course, they go away whenever you click somewhere, so they are a bit harder to catch. And we will see how to find where the code is creating the menu and where it is actually showing the menu. And that will be useful also for part six, where one of these actions in the menu, we want to see what code is being triggered when we click on it. And we can do that even if we don't actually know the code. We will find where the slot is actually written and executed. And finally, in part seven, we are going to look at debugging the painting of a widget so that we can understand what the code is doing. And in this example, we'll fix a wrong color that is being used for filling the background in some part of the widget. All of these things we'll be able to do with GammaRay, which is a free and open source tool developed by KDAB. You can install GammaRay from sources on GitHub, or if you're using Linux, it is surely part of your distribution already. So that's really easy to install. And if you're using Windows, you can find in the description a link to a video that will tell you how to actually install it on Windows. If you look around for KDAB videos about GammaRay, another video tells you how to attach GammaRay to a running application. But I would advise against doing that for these cases we are going to look at, because we want to see stack traces of the creation of the widgets. And if you attach at runtime, then the creation already happened and you get no stack trace. So it is a lot better if you actually start your application in GammaRay in the first place. That is it for this video. I hope you enjoy watching this series and have fun.